Johnson & Sons of Omaha, Nebraska, packers of America's best-known brand of canned and frozen poultry, presents the exciting television game, The Name's the Same. Let's meet our panel of famous names. Co-author of the Broadway hit Guys and Dolls, Abe Burrows. Famous radio and television actress, Joan Alexander. Well-known composer, conductor, and author, Meredith Wilson. And your host and moderator, another famous name, Robert June Lewis.
Thank you. Hi, everybody. Once again, welcome to The Name's the Same. Tonight, as usual, you're going to meet some people who have very famous names. Names the same as famous celebrities, well-known places, and, of course, panel things that we all know. And tonight, as always, it's up to our panel to determine those contestants' names through a process of cross-examination. To start our program, let's meet our first guest with a famous name. Now, may I ask where you're from?
St. Louis.
And what do you do?
I'm a saleswoman for Famous Bar, the most famous store in St. Louis.
Well, good for you. And may I say you look very attractive in those glasses.
Well, thank you.
Not at
you
all.
Very much.
Now, it's true, of course, this lady has a famous name, and panel, if you don't mind, I'll refer to her as Miss X from now on. Let's let our home audience see this lady's famous name. All right. Well, it's up to you to cross-examine Miss X to determine what her name is. Remember, you kids are competing with one another to see who guesses the name first. The losers pay. You have 10 questions apiece. If you use up your questions, you lose and must pay our contestant $25 by check. Miss X, you may answer yes or no as if you were the famous, inanimate object that your name represents. Miss X's name represents an inanimate object. And with that bit of help, let us start with Miss Alexander. Joni?
Well, since Miss X is a woman, I will ask, is this something generally used by women?
Pardon?
Is it something used by women?
Oh, yes.
Is it something which might give me a certain amount of pleasure or enjoyment?
Yes, I think it gives you a
very certain amount of pleasure and enjoyment.
Could this change my appearance in any way?
Yes, it might do things to you.
Might I use this just before going out on a date?
Yes. Very definitely.
Is this an intimate thing? I mean, would it touch my body in any way?
Yes, of course. Yes, it would touch your body. Yes.
Might my hairdresser use it?
Oh, yes.
Well, would she rub it into my hair or scalp?
I leave that to you. Would it be rubbed into Miss Alexander's hair or scalp? Would you? No.
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 Oh, I pass.
Mayor?
That's one question I can't ask. I cannot believe in my hair. Well, might a man use this, too, as well as a woman?
Yeah.
Does it have a distinctive odor?
Yeah.
It does have, huh? Does this come in a glass container?
Yeah.
I see. Wait a second now. If I poured this into my bath water, would it make it bubble?
Take it.
No. Maybe.
Wrong thing,
I'm afraid.
Abe, I'll pass.
Abe.
Is it something edible? If you have to look like that.
Yes. Yes, very definitely edible.
No, but I mean, you showed doubt. Are you withdrawing the doubt?
No, I withdraw the doubt. It is edible.
It is edible?
Yep.
I mean, commonly, when I say edible, I don't mean accidentally edible, like each straw.
No, you do this on purpose.
This is fool.
All right.
Is it highly spiced? Interesting.
Yeah.
Is it something that was once living?
Parts of it might have been.
pots up in there.
Well, isn't that about right? Yes. Well, no. I wouldn't go near that.
No.
But parts of it might have been. Yeah, I'll confuse you a little bit.
What you mean then, is it something that was, it is a food that is a prepared combination of foods?
That is right. Prepared combination.
Is vinegar used in the preparation of this?
No.
Not frequently.
When I said it was spice, you said yes, didn't you?
Well, now, of course, spice is a very definite thing. I thought you meant the adjective spiced or spicy, which might be applied to almost any type of flavor.
I do
not know whether there are actually any spices
employed. Look, old man, there's certain things which mean spice.
Well, on this program, we like not to go near that.
All right.
No.
This is not spicy like a dance. I mean spice like marjoram, basil, all those things.
Yes, there are no actual spices employed in the manufacture of this particular...
There are no spices.
There are not. You have five questions.
The living organism that this thing contains, if it contains any living thing which were formerly alive, was it a... nautical animal?
No.
Sea?
No.
That leaves land. What else is there? Sea, land, air. Was it a four-footed animal?
No, I've never seen it walking. Let's keep it rolling.
Was it a bird?
Well, you fly. No, it was not.
I can't.
All right, Joni.
Meredith said something before, and there was a laugh. He said if he poured it into the bathwater, would it make the bathwater bubble? Well, if I poured it into me, would it make me bubble?
It sure would.
Yeah. Is it some kind of a drink or something?
Yes, you have one question.
I'll pass. Let them do the
drink. All right,
Mary. Is this a manufactured preparation that you buy in a bottle?
I don't believe you can buy this preparation. Manufactured as is. I think you... Go ahead.
Is this something that you would prepare yourself at home for the purpose of a drink?
That
is its primary purpose.
Yes.
And you put things in there that used to be alive?
Well, now, I tell you what I'm going to do. Tell you what I'm going to do. I'm going to call time and tell you that this lady's name is Jim Ricky.
Oh, really?
Now, a lime... which is an integral part, they tell me, of a gin ricky was at one time a lime.
Who puts a lime in a gin ricky?
This does not constitute an endorsement by either the program, the sponsors, or the members of the panel. All right, my dear, Miss Ricky, thanks an awful lot. You're going to go over there and collect $75.
Do you think I can walk over there?
How many have you had? Thank you from the Swanson people for playing the names.
Thank you.
Nice to know. Now let's meet our next guest with a famous name. Where are you from, young man?
From North Arlington, New Jersey.
North Arlington, New Jersey. And what do you do?
I'm a student.
Go to school. Where?
Queen of Peace High.
All right. Now, panel, we've got another famous name, and I want the audience at home to see this gentleman's famous name. By now, you know the rules. You each have 10 questions, and Mr. X, you may answer yes or no. All right, let's start right around here. Meredith, you begin, will you?
All right, sir. Are you a human being, Mr. X?
Yes.
Are you living?
Yes.
Are you an American?
Yes.
Uh-huh. Are you connected with the arts and show business or in any other form of the arts?
No.
No. Are you connected with politics?
No.
Are you interested in sports?
Yes.
You are. Do you play baseball?
Yes.
I see. Were you happy today or sad?
You can't answer that. What? Take it one.
Were you happy today?
No.
You have two questions, Matt.
Woo-hoo-hoo.
But very well done. Very well.
Is your first name Joe?
No.
You only have one.
One question, man.
I'm going to husband it.
Go ahead, Abe.
Give me the chance of your life, then.
Well, then I just have to say you were happy today. Unhappy today. I'll just have to ask you a question. Are you with the New York Yankees?
Yes.
Are you an active player?
Yes.
Are you a member of the infield?
Yes.
You know what she just said to me, this girl here?
What?
She says, watch the infield.
I'm going to say something else to you. Explain. The Yankees lost today.
Explain something about the infield. What's the infield?
Yeah. What? The Yankees infield lost today.
Infield is where they sit, up on top.
He ain't happy if he's a Yankee, right. Lad.
You have seven questions, Abe. Let's keep it rolling. Were you originally of Italian descent?
Yes.
Are you a catcher?
Yes.
Are you Yogi Barra?
Yes.
Of course, when we got this Yogi's name, we just couldn't believe it. But this is legitimate Yogi Barra. Yogi, let me ask you a question. Before you go over there to pick up your money, your $25 from Joan and from Meredith, have you ever met Yogi Barra, the famous Yankee player?
No.
Well, I think we've got a real treat for you as well as our viewers tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, the famous namesake of this gentleman, Mr. Yogi Barra. Well, this Yogi, I think if you wait till after the show, this Mr. Barra will be glad to give you his autograph, maybe a ball or something like that. But meanwhile, you go on over there, collect your checks, and thanks from the Swanson people for playing the names the same. Yogi, how are you? I saw you today. I expressed no opinion either way, but it was a great game. It was a great game. Now we come to the I'd like to be portion of our program. Before the show started, Yogi told us who he might like to be, just in fun, of course, if he weren't the star catcher for the Yankees. Panel, we'll see if you can determine who that person is in just a moment. But first, our lovely Jean Sullivan is going to show us how to serve a dish like Mother used to make.
When Mother made chicken pie, she worked hard, shopping and cooking. Why, she had to buy chicken, peas, pimentos, spices, and, of course, flour and shortening for the crust. Oh, Mother's chicken pies were very good, but preparing them was a lot of hard work. But today, you can serve Mother's kind of chicken pie without hard work. Just serve Swanson quick frozen chicken pie. You don't even have to thaw it. Just take it out of the carton, pop it into the oven, brown, and serve. Then you have a homemade kind of chicken pie with a flaky crust that bakes to a crispy golden brown and filled with extra large pieces of tender, juicy chicken, rich golden gravy, pimentos, and plump green peas. Swanson quick frozen chicken pie can be baked and served in its own shiny aluminum dish. Afterwards, you can use these helpful little dishes for gelatin molds, for storing foods in the refrigerator, or for coasters, ashtrays, or for flower pot holders. So, friends, serve the kind of chicken pie that Mother used to make, but do it the easy way with Swanson quick frozen chicken pie. Remember, Swanson, the name of the finest chicken in the land.
May I say that that chicken pie is a bachelor's delight. You go home, you light the oven, you stick it in, it's wonderful. Real delicious.
Bob, it's wow. A married man's delight, too, because my wife can't cook.
She doesn't have to with this stuff, believe me. All right, now we're set to play I'd Like to Be. Our panel's going to try to find out who it is Yogi would like to be if he weren't himself. Let's let our home audience see that famous name. All right, panel, we play as we did before, and the loser's checks go to Yogi Barra's favorite charity. Let's start off with Abe Burrows, the cook.
Larry, how are you? This person you want to be, is he an athlete?
Nope.
Is he in show business?
No, I don't think so.
Does he work?
Well, sure.
I mean, does he have an income? Does he work for a living? Does he do something?
Well, sure he does.
I know a lot of ball players would just like to lay off, you know. Is he in the field of politics?
No, I don't think so.
I pass. Joni.
You said he had an income. Would he be considered a kind of playboy?
No, hardly.
Is he an industrialist?
No.
Is it a she?
Nope.
They're both, Mr. Barron. No, not
you
a
you sure boy. You know what you're doing?
He's just as comfortable as he is here as he is behind the plate. Go on, Joe.
I mean you.
No, I don't know the first thing about this whole thing. Good
night. He's doing great. He's not a playboy, he's not in politics, he's not in sports, and he's not in show business.
Yes, does he drink?
What else could he be? Gee. Pat.
All right, ma'am.
Is he a writer, Yogi?
He is, has written many, many things, yes.
He has written? Is that his primary
claim to fame?
Is he generally known for that?
He is known for his writings, yes.
I see.
But it's not his primary claim. That should be two questions there, but what the heck? We're liberals. Go on, then, ma'am.
All right. Is he an artist, in any sense of the word?
In a sense of the word, yes, but there again, that would not be his primary claim to fame.
And we've mentioned politics, I believe. I'm just inquiring.
Yes.
Yes. He is a writer part-time. He's an artist part-time. Does he play the flute?
Not the flute, no.
Not the flute,
not
eh?
The flute.
No. Well, we've established he's not in show business. He's a part-time writer and different things.
Uh-huh.
Is he in science in any way? A doctor, let us say.
Yes.
A doctor, eh?
Yes.
Did he write a very famous book that was not fiction, but it was a collection of things,
yes.
Important things.
Yes.
Uh-huh.
Go ahead.
What? Would you wish to be Dr. Kinsey, by any chance?
No.
What?
He wouldn't.
No.
You wouldn't? I'm going to lay off, Abe.
Hey.
Is this man a great, great, great scientific mind?
Well, yeah.
Does he have a lot more hair than I got?
Doesn't everybody?
Yogi, don't tell me that you want to be Albert Einstein.
Attaboy.
All right, Johnny, Meredith, write out your checks for $25 apiece. Yogi, I'll ask you to go over there to pick up those checks. And thanks a lot from the Swanson people for playing the names the same. Thanks. Good luck tomorrow.
Good luck tomorrow, sir. I've got to
meet our next guest with a famous name. May I ask you where you're from, sir?
Shrewsbury, Massachusetts.
Massachusetts. And what do you do? What do you do in Massachusetts?
Drive a taxi cab.
Drive a taxi cab. Good for you. Now, we know you've got a very famous name. Before we play our game, let's let our home audience see this gentleman's famous name. This is the gentleman's name. Our legal experts have checked his authenticity. I think you know how we play our game, panel. Mr. X's name, may I tell you, represents a thing. Joan Alexander, would you start, please?
Thing. Is this something that I might use?
Yes.
Yes.
Would I enjoy using it?
Very much.
Could I ever use this in my work?
You're an actress, are you not?
I was, yes, today. I mean,
you were. And I think that, yes, there might be an occasion for you to use this in your work.
An actress, huh?
Yes.
Well, then, would I generally use this in front of an audience?
I
No, I don't think so. No.
Hey, kid, you got sucked into that talk about you being an actress. That's all. Silly.
Would I be more likely, then, to use it in front of friends?
Well, wait a minute. You mean more likely to use it in front of friends than in front of an audience?
Yes, that's right.
Well, in that case, yes, it'd be more likely to use it in front of friends than your audience. Yes.
Well, then, in reverse, if friends came to my house, might they use it?
They might, yes.
Is it possible that if I gave a party...
Joni!
You don't think I ever Joni,
the answer is no. Whatever it is.
I never entertain anyone. These people are hysterical.
You better just stop where you are. Atta girl.
Now, the thing that Joan uses, could I use it too?
Yes.
I could.
Yeah.
Just require great skill to use this?
I would say none at all.
None?
No.
Well, might this be used for fun or relaxing?
Well, that is its primary purpose.
Yes, its primary purpose. Does it have any replaceable parts?
Yes.
It has replaceable parts.
Mm-hmm.
Is it used outside the house?
Sure.
Yes.
Uh-huh.
Could you go from place to place in this thing?
Go from place to place in the thing?
Yeah.
No.
Oh, it's more stationary type thing.
More or less.
Oh, well, that gives me an idea. If I were to fill this with water, could I dive into it?
Well, kid, what do you say?
I don't think so.
I don't think so either.
Couldn't do it, eh?
No.
Abe, I'm through.
We have only 2.5 minutes, Bannel.
Well, let's see now. Everybody's been jumping into this thing. Joan has had it at a party. She's been acting with it. Is this thing, which thing it is? Is it a manufactured thing?
Yes.
All right. Let's see what's manufactured. Is it a thing which could be a thing which other things are put into?
Put into?
Into. I-N-T-W-O.
Into. N-O. No.
What does that mean? Oh,
I don't know what it means.
Please don't spell it to me. I'm tired tonight. Just say it away. I don't get it. And nothing can be... In other words, it's not a receptacle.
It is not a receptacle.
All right. Is it manufactured of metal? Don't look so pale.
No. I don't know. They're all... No, I suppose not. No.
Oh, you don't suppose not?
I don't suppose not, no.
You said, I suppose not.
Would you continue, please? We have only a minute and a half.
You mean it could be manufactured out of metal?
It could not.
It could not? Possibly?
Science marches on. Someday, maybe.
It's made from something which was once a living object.
Come on, you hear the other thing. At parts of it. Yeah.
I'll wait for you.
Parts of it, parts of it.
Parts of it, all right. Now tell me. He's a taxi driver. Is it New York taxi driver, by the way?
No, Massachusetts.
Hey, do you have your name up over the... in the cab? In Massachusetts?
But Dave is asking if your name in view.
Yes.
Do people bust out laughing when they see your name?
Sometimes.
All right.
Is the name a name that's ordinarily called an American name?
American name?
What, you know, Abe, this is a good point. Actually, thank the good Lord, almost every name is an American name.
You don't understand what I mean. I mean originally American, as against...
You mean Pocahontas? We have only about 30 seconds now.
Well, I was going to guess a garbage can, you see. I think of a film.
Well, not quite. You have 3 questions and very little time remains.
A taxi, is it something that's mostly used in the kitchen?
No, that's a good trick. I'm sorry, I'm going to have to call time. I should like you to meet a mattress. And if you want to keep yours in the kitchen, Abe, go to it. That's about all the time we have. Mr. Mattress, I'm going to ask you to go over there to pick up your checks from Abe Burrows, from Joan Alexander, and from Meredith Wilson, I bet you do get a lot of kicks with a name like that.
I do.
Well, thanks very much for being on our show. Thanks a lot from the Swans, folks. Go on over there and pick up your money. We'll be back in a moment, folks, to tell you how our panel did and a little bit about next week's show. But first, how about going with Gene Sullivan to a street I think we'd all love to live on?
Yes, everyone likes to live on Easy Street. And I know one way to get there. It's the Swanson way. The workless way to easy cooking with Swanson Quick Frozen Pies. Just choose the part you like best. All thighs. So easy to fix. So wonderfully tasty. Or all livers. So easy to fix. So tender and flavorful. Or all breasts, all wings, all drumsticks, and whole cut-up fryers. Whatever favorite part you choose, all you do is thaw, pop them into the pan, and in no time at all, they're ready. Golden, tender, tasty. So good to eat. So easy to fix. Yes, friends, Swanson points the way to Easy Street, where you save time and work. So remember, for easy cooking and your favorite chicken pods, the name's the same. Swanson, the name of the finest chicken in the land.
That chicken. All right, let's have a little accounting now. Meredith Wilson, will you make your report, please?
Yes, yes, reluctantly. I will, Bob. I lost $100 tonight, but I'll be a big man around the house because I shook hands with Yogi Barra. Good night, all.
All right, Joni Alexander, how about you?
I lost $100, too, and can't think of anything to say. Good night, everybody.
Good night, Johnny. Hey, Buzz, what about you?
I lost $50. Only. Good night, everybody.
Good night, Kylo. Considering everything, you did very well tonight. So long, folks. The G.A. Swanson & Sons, Packers of America's best-known brand of canned and frozen poultry. Panel and I will see you again next week on The Name's the Same, which will be brought to you by Bendix Home Appliances.
Friends, be sure to enter the great Bendix Rinso Contest. The prizes are terrific. Over $100,000 worth of wonderful Bendix Perfect Pairs. And you could be a winner. Just tell us on an official entry blank in 25 words or less why you vote for Rinso. Get your entry blank from your friendly Bendix dealer or wherever Rinso is sold. Enter the great Bendix Rinso Contest now. Remember, you could win a Bendix Perfect Pair, the remarkable new Bendix Tumble Action Automatic Washer, and the matching Bendix Automatic Dryer. The Name's the Same has been a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. Associate producer, Peter Arnell. Directed by Jerome Schnorr. Technical Director, John Broderick. Miss Alexander's gone by Paul Park. This is Lee Vine speaking for C.A. Swanson & Sons, reminding you to tune in each and every week at the same time for The Name's the Same.